blessing away. Do you know that? What the Lord has gifted you, there is no way he can take that gift away. What the Lord has chosen you, there is no way he can take that anointing away. But what happens is, when you rebel against him, he will make that blessing, that anointing, that favor, that gift to rot. Amen.
Amen.
In the book of Genesis, the Bible says that the Lord created the heavens and the earth, and everything that the Lord created was good. He planted the garden of Eden in the east and watered it. Yes, he did a divine planned irrigation scheme in the garden of Eden by creating four rivers, that four golden rivers to water the garden of Eden. And he placed a man in that garden to till it and keep it. And his life was good. He used to eat without sweat. He used to be naked without shame. But a man rebelled against the Lord. This man, Adam, rebelled against the Lord. And the Lord said, out of my garden, but you are still on earth, because I gave you power and dominion to subdue this earth that I gave. So I will not take the earth out of your life, but I will give it to you because I'm the one who gave you. God's gifts are without regret. So after some time, he cursed Adam and told him, now because you rebelled against me, in your sweat you shall eat. Meaning, you have to stink to eat. Yeah? Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Yes, in your sweat you shall eat. And because of you, the whole earth is cursed. What else if you say?
Amen.
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 Many people are blessed, but their blessings are rotten. And when a blessing is rotten, it stinks. Why? But why? It is because of rebellion. Sin means rebellion against God. So when you sin, you make your blessings to rot. There are people, when you look them at a distance, they look magnificent. They look, they have the gift, they have the talent, they have the favor. But when you move close to them, yes, you discover this person has a lot of problems. In Lingala, we say makambo, eh? I wonder if you say that. This man has a lot of problems. He has the idea, but he can't convert that idea into blessings or into money. He has a degree, but he can't convert that degree into money. He has that favor, but he can't convert that favor into moving the masses. Why? Because he has a blessing that is stinking because of sin. There is a man whom I know. This man is gifted. This man is gifted with handiworks. Yes, this man can take it. There's a cupboard, he can be a carpenter, he can be a mason, and so forth. Very, very, many things. But this man is nothing but a stinking mess. His gifts and talents cannot help him even to pay his rents. He's always on debts. He's always on the begging side. He's always a beggar. He's always, let me use this word, he's totally impoverished. And there is nothing that gets out of this man. Why? Because besides being a believer, besides being a man of God, yes, he has a blessing that the Lord has given him, but because of his meanness. Yes, because he's too mean. He's a miser. He can't give, he can't share his ideas with others for others to grow like him. Yes, that's why he has the gifts and talents, but they can't help him. Let me tell you one thing about a believer. Once the Lord calls you, yes, there is no way you can save your money in your wallet. Do you know that? And if a saving will come, it will not be called a saving, but a leftover. When the Lord has blessed you abundantly, yes, you will remain with leftovers. It's not that, I'm not saying that a believer cannot save completely, cannot have something to take care of him in, or her in future. But what happens is, once the Lord has called you, you can't save by yourself. But God will one day bless you abundantly for the leftover to remain, so that you keep it for your future. Amen. Njoo juzi nilikuwa naangalia how I spend my money kwa M-Pesa. Naangalia mwezi nilitumia this amount. These are huge, huge amounts of money that I spend per month. That's my M-Pesa kama ningekuwa nayo hivi. Sasa hivi ningekuwa na drive a very serious engine, eh? Bwana asifiwe sana. But why? Nikafika mahali mpaka nikaanza kulia. Hey, I spend too much. Yeah? I really spend too much. But they not told me repent. Do you know why? Because the money that you're spending, it is the money that I'm giving you to spend. I haven't given you money to keep or to keep for your old age that will help you in future. When that moment comes, yes, I'm telling you, you will have more than enough that you will be forced to keep in your bank account. But for now, just do as you normally do. And that's why as many people who are called by God, yes, even if you earn that salary, even if you are in business, there is no way you can save in your initial stages of your workmanship. Do you know that? Amen. Amen. Bonus if you sir. And that's why you account at zeros. And that's that when you try to save your money, it will just go like that. She does that, okay, and they will take that money away. If you won't help that person who is asking you for your help, that money will just vanish. Why? Exodus. The book of Exodus, chapter 16, answers that question very well. Exodus 16, verse 19 and 20. The Bible says, and Moses said, let no one leave of it till morning. Notwithstanding, they hearkened not to Moses, but some of them left off it until the morning, and it bred worms and stank, and Moses was angry with them. Yes, this is the story of manna. Manna is a blessing, was a blessing to the children of Israel. It was the food that the Lord used to feed the Israelites with in the wilderness, miraculously. Once you are saved, I'm telling you, even if you are in your wilderness, yes, let me tell you, once the Lord calls you, and once the Lord wants to use you in truth and in spirit, He must organize a season of feeding you miraculously. And once you are feeding miraculously, I'm telling you, that season of feeding, of the Lord feeding you miraculously, there is no way you can save even a single coin. It's just a season. It's not your permanent situation, but a season, a transitional season that will take you to your promised land. What else if you say?
Amen.
So, the Bible says that these people were eating the manna. Yes. And after eating the manna, they used to keep it for future use, so that they may not suffer or struggle tomorrow. Bonus if you will, sir.
Amen.
Let me go back, you know. When the Lord called the children of Israel, they used to be fed by the Egyptians. They used to depend on this paganistic nation called Egypt. That's what happened to you and me. Yes, when the Lord called you, there was someone who used to feed you. There was someone who used to depend on. There was that job that used to worship. But it reaches a point where the Lord takes that help from you. Do you know that?
Amen.
There is reached a point that the Lord takes that husband away. He takes that child away. He takes that job away. Yes. To show you that He can feed you without that husband. To show that He can feed you without that job. To show that He can feed you without that salary. Without that business. It is not a demon, it's the Lord. It's the workmanship of God. Why is the Lord doing this? The Lord is creating a testimony. Remember, a believer without a testimony is a weakling. A believer is a believer with a testimony. A testimony is what makes a believer a believer. Bueno, así fue, sir. So it is not rejection. It is not confusion, but a testimony in the making. And that's why there is a season in life that you spend too much not for your personal gain, but for the sake of others. And if you pass that test perfectly, yes, the Lord will usher you into another grace of your promised land. But that process takes long. It took 40 years. Bonus if you will. Yes, it may take 10 years, 5 years, 6 months, according to the will of God. Yes, whereby the Lord will make you a desolate, a reject. Yes, a person who just spent his money anyhow, to the extent that you call meetings to yourself and asking yourself, hey, but I really spend money. I don't have even a bank account. I don't have a future. When I look at myself, yes, I just get hand to mouth. I've been typing for all these years, but debts are still surrounding. It is a season, a transitional season that is going to usher you into a next level. And I'm telling you, if you fail to give, if you hoard, yes, if you hoard your resources to help, to pay your tithes, to secure your future, I'm telling you, the Lord will send worms to eat what you have hidden. Worms in form of sickness, worms in form of police arrest, worms in form of court cases, worms in form of any calamity that is ever discovered by the sons of men that takes away your money. So you better give. One has few, sir.
Amen.
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 The children of Israel, yes, used to hoard, used to hide part of the manna for the sake of their future. They applied logic in the calling. You know, the moment you apply logic in your calling, you fail. That's why the Bible says, do not worry about tomorrow. Tomorrow will worry about itself. Yeah? What else if you with that?
Amen.
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 Yes, how many times have you worried about tomorrow? A believer who worries about tomorrow is a cursed believer. Just live one day at a time. Once the Lord has called you, there is no way you can apply reason to stamp your calling. What else if you say?
Amen.
Yes, if you used to give genuinely from your heart, if you used to sacrifice yourself genuinely from your heart, there is no way you can suffer nor your children beg for bread. The Bible says that I was young and now I'm old. I've never seen a righteous man forsaken, nor his descendants begging for bread. If you do the will of God, it may not be logic nor reason. It may be out of logic. It may not make sense. But I'm telling you, even if that donor cuts off supply from you, even if that person cuts off his help from you, you will still live, you will still survive, and you will thrive in Jesus' name. A man shall not live alone by bread alone, but by every word that comes from the mouth of God. The Bible says that these children of Israel used to hoard, used to hide part of manna, but the moment that they were doing that, during the night, the Lord used to send worms to eat the manna that they were hoarding. Yeah? Yes, I have a salary, but I have to hide it because I need this salary to pay my rent and save for my future. Yeah? I can't pay my tithe because my salary is tight for my budget. I'm telling you, if you do that, the Lord will send worms in your salary, and it will not help you 100%. Yeah? Why? Because you don't trust in God. You can't fund God with your salary. God has more than enough. So what God does, he just wants to test you. Abraham, you have been praying for a child for all 100 years. You have been praying and trusting me for a child. Now I've given you an Isaac, and I want you to sacrifice that same Isaac unto me. Abraham said, Lord, as you have said, I will do it. And because of that, the Lord refreshed and renewed the covenant he had with Abraham and said, truly, you are my friend. I will bless your descendants, and I'll give them the land that I showed you. And through you, all the generations of this earth are blessed. What else if you, sir? Yes, if you want to be a blessing into your generation. If you want a generation of blessing into your family, yes, you have to serve God boldly. And you don't have to worry too much about your moral. Your moral is in the God's hands, and you can do nothing about it. Bonus if you will, sir.
Amen.
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 Yes. Why are you holding? Why are you holding what the Lord has blessed you with? Why are you too much focused on your future? Your future belongs to God. Your present is a gift from God. Concentrate in what you have. A bird in hand, what's two in the bush?
Amen.
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 Yes, your manna is not meant to the fridge. It is not meant to your cupboard. It is not meant to the underbed. Isn't it? Yes. It is not meant to such places. It meant to be consumed as at that time. Bwana asifiwe sana.
Amen.
That's why sometimes, sisi wachungaji ndio tunapitia mambo kama hiyo. Sasa umepata tu pesa, pap. Ni kama watu wa shida wanajuanga umepata pesa. Man of God sijalipa rent. Man of God nimeshikwa. Man of God mtoto wangu sijui amefukuzwa school fees. Man of God sina chakula. Man of God, this is how you distribute. Yeah? Ukienda kwa nende pesa umetoa. Bwana asifiwe sana. Amen.
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 The Bible says that he who is given more, more is demanded from him. When the Lord bless you more, yes, more will be demanded from you. Sometimes we cry, oh, I have a lot of money, but I don't know what I do, what that money do. Because I'm always broke. I'm always living on the debit side, helping people, cashing out my money to people. Yet I'm in need. I need the same money to buy myself clothes, shoes, and anything, any personal thing that I need. But my money is just flying. It's just like they have wings. You have to thank God because you are a distributor. Yes, you have to thank God because of that grace of distribution. You have to thank God because people, someone can call you and tell you, please, lend me 10,000, lend me 5,000. That means you are blessed. Eh?
Amen.
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 But come on, akanga, tuwakuna mbana kukopata mia. What else do you say? That means, what are you doing? This man is a cursed. Eh? Am I making sense?
Yes.
What was on Gamtik or Matunda Simtik or empty? So sometimes when you lend them money and they fail to pay, yeah? You have to thank God, say, hey, I'm not from Ghana, because they see that I have the money. Take those if you take it to Denny's, about 30 bob or 50 bob. Take it to Chaka Pati, put that as if you were saying.
Amen.
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 Hey, that's a sign. That you are blessed. Sisi kama kuna watu hapa wameenda kwa hizi hoteli, 5-star hotels. Hata wacha 5-star hotels, 3-star hotels. Yeah? Yes, if you go to such hotels, you must give out tips from the gate man to the waiter. Do you know that? That is a law. Why? Because once you step inside that hotel, people know that this man is a blessing. That gate man in the gate is that waiter who is serving. He knows that he's serving a king. And once he serves a king, he must get something out of it. Yes, and once he gets something out of it, he will just say, oh, I served a king. And once he said like that in his heart, the Lord will glorify you. And that's why people give tips. Bonus if you will, sir. Bonus if you will, sir. Am I talking to someone today? Am I talking to someone today?
Yes.
So whoever keeps his money for the sake of his future and yet your salary that you are earning today is just a peanut. It cannot sustain your future. It cannot sustain your wife, your children. So if you hoard for the sake of your wife instead of giving those who are in need of the same money, I'm telling you, you'll have a bleak future. You'll have a gloom future. Because it will never multiply to to your expectations. But whoever trusts in the Lord for his future, I'm telling you, yes, I'm giving not because I have, but because I know the same God who have given me this money to give will give me my supply tomorrow. In why? Because the Bible says that he who remembers God in the days of his youth, the Lord shall remember in his old age. So I'm giving because I have God. I don't have an account because I have God. I don't save money because I don't have more than enough to save. But because I have God, I will give and do what the Lord has called me to do. Once you do like that, I'm telling you, even if that boss sucks you from that job, you will survive. You will thrive. What does it matter? If Jamal put on for 2 years, but I couldn't do it. Na vile mtu aliishi, it's just a miracle. Mtu kuna mtu aliniambia testimony moja. Hiyo testimony ilinishika sana. This person alipoteza kazi. Huyo mtu akujua aliniguza. He lost a job. And this person ako na ministry of giving. So akateseka. Akashinda sasa what next? Akaangalia akasema hata enda kwa watu wao. Hata enda kwa marafiki. Yeye anatumainia Mungu. So this person told me that alikuwa ameenda in a prayer center na akakutana na mtu huko. Na huyo mtu akamkaribisha kwake. So aliishi na huyo mtu for some time. Mpaka vile alipata another job na akatoka kwa huyo mtu. Just imagine losing your job, staying for almost 1 year without a job, getting a job, yeah, and your life is still kicking. And going, and no one discovered that person lost a job. Why? The Lord was showing this person that without this job, I'm still your God. Without that salary, I'm still your job, where you are God. Without that account, without that saving, I'm still your God. I can rescue you, I can feed you, I can clothe you, and I can shelter you. Why? Because I'm the Lord in heaven. What else if you sir? So giving is not a waste of time. Helping others is not a waste of time. You shall not hoard. You shall not keep what it is meant to be given. Amen.
Amen.
Am I making sense to someone today? Why? Because if you hoard, if you keep it, the Lord will send worms and they will consume it. Because that money that the Lord wants you to give, it is not yours. It belongs to the person you are giving. So the Lord is asking, yes. You traded for it, but I'm the one who gave you the money. So, as I gave you that money, I don't give you that money to help you, but to give that person, to give that needy person, to support that ministry. And once you do that, I'm telling you, the cup of your blessings in heaven increases even more and more and more in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
The bonus if you will say.
Amen.
Yes, the Lord cannot take your blessings away, but he can make your blessings to stink. There is this other person whose child wanted to be a pastor. His child was too much into the ministry and later vowed that he will serve God all the days of his life. So, the parents noticed that this child is too much into the church. And his parents were believers also. This is a real story. So, his parents said to themselves that if we leave this child of ours into the hands of pastors, they will confuse his life. What else if you said? So they orchestrated behind the scenes to discourage their child to walk out of the ministry. Yes, by invoking and feeding this child with negativity concerning the ministry. Telling this child of theirs that kanisa watu ni maskini, people are poor, but you get your own kitu at kadhalikas. So at the end of the day, this person was, people tried to advise this parent, please, If your child is called, you don't have to stand on his or her way. Let that child serve God. But the pilot said that even if the Lord allows, even if the Lord comes and tell us to release our child into the ministry, we'll never do it. Hey, what a blasphemy. And they were telling the pastor of that child. So at the end of the day, the pastors were going to call, the elders were going to call, the leaders were going to call, okay, so be it. So the Lord gave you that child with knowledge, with brightness. He was bright. This child was too bright in school. Akapata grades vizuri. Kaenda campus vizuri. Akamaliza campus vizuri. Why? Because the Lord has blessed her. The God has blessed this child. And there is no way he can take the blessings away. But what the Lord did, he made the blessings of that child and the entire family to rot. For that family to be nothing but a stinking family. Now, a teacher point, someone was calling me yesterday night, telling me that that family okay, to make the story short, mama ameamua kuingia kwa usherati, mtoto ameingia kwa usherati, mwingine amekuwa kola. The family is scattered kwa giza. Why? The blessing is there, the degrees are there, the knowledge is there, but all these things are stinky, are nothing but stinking mess. Amen. Amen. Even if it is your child, it doesn't mean that you're the one who owned that child. That child is just a gift from God. You are just a custodian as a parent. But if you blaspheme against God because you have a child, yes, the blessings of that child will rot and stink. And you'll never get anything out of that child. Amen. Yes, that's what happens. Ukipata mtu ameenda amejenga nyumba kubwa lakini amelaaniwa. The Lord may not take that house sometimes. We just leave that house unto him. But that what the Lord will do, will make that house to stink. What anakuwa iangalia kama monument. Ile nyumba inaiona ni 8 bedrooms. But hakuna mtu anaweza ingia ndani because watoto ni wakora, drugs, watu ni wagonjwa, watu wako kwa death bed. That house is stinking. What else if you say?
Amen.
The rotten blessings. You have that blessing, but it is rotten. It is rotten. It is stinking. Why? Because of a rebellious heart. Why? Because of sin. Why? Because you decided to do things by your own. You focus too much on your future than your God. A rich fool, he cultivated his land very well. He built more barns because of bumper harvest. But in his heart he said that this year I'll just say, let's eat, drink, and enjoy. But the watchers were watching him in heaven, from heaven. And the Lord said that you fool today, I need your soul in paradise. And that was the end of it. The bumper harvest in the barns started rotting. The Lord didn't take the harvest out of his hands. But what the Lord did, he took this man away to leave his barns without attendance. And as you know very well, that ukieka chakula mahali, na usiangalie vizuri, usishughulikie kama ni mahindi uitoe uanike urudishe. It will rot. And it will not help you. It will stink. And it will be the end of you. So you have to be very careful. And that's why you have people who have gifts. People who have talents. But they are hiding it. They don't want to use it. Once you do that, the Lord will make that gift rot. There are people who have ideas that can help them in the ministry, but they don't want to do it because of personal reasons. Once you do that, the Lord will make that ministry reviewers to stink. There are people who are gifted in music, in preaching. Some have testimonies. But something funny is, they can't testify because of personal reasons. Once your testimony is not shared, or a testimony not shared, is a rotten testimony. Yes, it will rot. Why? Because for another testimony to come, you have to unleash what you have. The Lord can never bless hands that are full. Before the Lord bless your hands, He must make sure that He empties what you have. Remember, the Bible says that by the word of their testimonies, they defeated the devil. He who has the Son has a testimony. And sometimes we call people who have a testimony, they want to testify. They don't want to testify. What does it mean? I'm telling you, even your health is a testimony. If you sit on it, it will start rotting. And it will rot and stink. And this will not attract another testimony, another blessing unto you. Am I making sense to someone today?
Amen.
When the Lord blessed Nebuchadnezzar, He gave him the power to rule over the great Babylonian Empire. When this man misbehaved because of pride and rudeness, the Bible says that he was stricken with madness for 12 months. Then after some, not 12 months, but 7 years, sorry, yeah. But after some time, his sanity was regained, and he said to himself, "Blessed be the Lord of hosts in heaven." Because he's the one who promotes and he's the one who demotes. Whoever is pride, he obeys. He has the power to abase or to humble in simpler terms. A time has come, and that time is now. You shall not keep to yourself what God has meant to be given. What is supposed to be given? It must be given. No matter how hard you have fought for it, no matter how hard you have worked for it, what the Lord has commanded you to give, it must be given, because it is not yours. If you keep it, it will rot and will have a gloom future. Am I making sense to someone today?
Yes.
Am I making sense to someone today?
Yes.
A believer's future is not secured by savings or petty savings, if I may put it that way. But if it is a must that you save, the Lord will automatically bless you with more than enough that leftovers to remain for your future use. That's what happened during the turning of 5 loaves of bread and 2 fishes. The blessings of God that appertains to the anointed ones of God, must have leftovers. But if you receive resources that are without leftovers, then that resource that you have received is not yours. It belongs to those who ask for it. Eh? Let me put it in Swahili. From today, ukiona unapata pesa, ama unapata resources. Resources ni rasilimali. Zile, zinakutosha, na zinatosha kupeana. Then you should not hold. Especially when you meet people who need that resource, who need that resource that you have. But it reaches a point if God wants you to save, actually, He will bless you, He will just make a way to bless you with abundance. Yes, hata kubariki na mingi zaidi ile baraka itakulazimu to say. It will just force you to say whether you like it or not. That's how God blesses his people. So your 100 per month salary is not your destiny. That is just a seed that the Lord is giving you to sow. That 200 Kenya shilling salary that you earn per month, it is not your destiny. It is not your blessing. It does not define you in terms of your future blessings. That one belongs to the people that the Lord is organizing, orchestrating to come for you for their help. Amen.
Amen.
There is a man, sorry story. There is a man who blessed me so much. And you know my nature. Nikona mtu anibariki sana kumwambia hapana enough. Bwana asifiwe sana. So that man blessed me, blessed me. I want to see you. Let me come here. Come to my house. Please, from today, don't give it. Don't give. Sasa, hizo pesa zako. Because you have a family, keep it. I don't need your resources. From today. Nasikwa ubaya, please. Hey, that man anijangadaka. Please, man of God. Don't say that. Do you know that you paid my rents for 5 good years? Hey! Do you know that you used to feed me for all those years? Niki, shima ni wewe nilikuwa napigia simu. Mimi sasa kumbuka hiyo hapa nilikuwa nafanya hivyo. Bwana asifiwe sana. So, besides giving this as an offering, it's an appreciation because of what you used to do for me. Hey, I really want that. Kumbi, Bwana asifiwe sana. Amen. Kuna sometimes sisi wachungaji, sisi utawaga tu pesa bila hata kujua. Eh? Saidia mtu unasahau completely because akili yako iko occupied. You know? And sometimes when we give, we don't even record on record. Kumbe kuna watu record, this man wants help. There was another day, the estate that I was nurtured, I met someone. And that person akaniambia, hey, dude, truly the Lord has blessed you. Unajua kwa nini Mungu alikubariki? I used to come into your house. Na si mimi peke yangu, tulikuwa group ya vijana. We used to tow your house. Kila siku saa 7. Tunakaa, tunapika ugali na omena. Tunakula. Eh? Ndizo siku nilikuwa na shida. And the days that I used to do those things, hata sikumbukangi by the others, I don't even remember kama niwahi kula na mtu kwa meza moja. But that man reminded me that we used to feed in your house those days. Mesa soko si kuwa na kazi, ndio nilikuwa kwa wilderness, ile wilderness beyond wilderness. Hey, I was really shocked. Bwana asifiwe sana. But this man was telling me, you are like this. Sisi tumeparara, hatuna kitu. But wewe ni kama una kitu vile I see you, you have money. But you are like this because you used to feed us. Hey, let me tell you one testimony about myself. You know, mi kutoka nizaliwe. Kutoka nianze kuishi peke yangu wa zamani. Sijawahi kula chakula peke yangu for the whole day at a lunch, breakfast and supper. Do you know that? Hata zile siku nilikuwa kwa wilderness, in the midst of the wilderness of my wilderness. Kumbe I used to eat with people that I don't even recall because nilikuwa na shida mpaka nilikuwa naweza chakula zangu zilikuwa ni kama kalongolongo. Bwana asifiwe sana. Amen. Amen. But kumbe there are some people who are still remembering the things that I used to do and then those days that I don't even remember. Hey. So what you are doing today, it is a seed that you are sowing that someone somewhere will remind you that you are like this because you used to do like this with a clean heart. So if you are a giver, give. If you are a singer, sing. If you are an intercessor, intercede. If you are an encourager, encourage. Encourage that person. Because in due season, you shall reap. Am I talking to someone today?
Yes.
Am I talking to someone today?
Yes.
But if you hold ukificha. If you hold what the Lord has given you, it will rot. That's why you know what you miss. Utapata mtu ameokoka for all those years, but maisha yake never shines. Ajaibu na mtu akamwambia, hey, you look smart. Ajaibu na mtu akamwambia, thank you for what you did to me last time. You know, Kristo kama hao. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Yes, kupata mshirika kama huyu unapata huyu mshirika maisha yake, not mshirika, huyu mkristo, sorry. Maisha yake ainaga glory. Akitembea tembea like a walking stronghold. Why? Because those who have, it is added unto them. But those who don't have, even the little that they have is taken away. So at least you have something to offer. And do it, even in the midst of your poverty, in the midst of your desert. Do it. You're not doing it to that person. You're not doing it to that church. You're not doing it to that sister or brother. You're doing it because of He whom called you. And once you do that, He records in heaven. He records in heaven. He records in heaven. And the season, the period that your enemies were prophesying that after this season, this brother will be completely crushed and will be a nobody. In fact, that season, when those seasons, and the days of those seasons are running out, is the counts the days or the beginnings or the genesis of your blessings. That's why you're not waking up, but there's some people here who to a family and go for a night off. We're gonna go mezenu, donors, relatives, wanguapati ultimatum, wanguapesema mutaweza. Tukikata supply, amutaweza. But funny enough, wanoranga tu bado mko. Bado nyinyi wasafi, mnaoga, mnakula, mnaishi. Bado kama nina shida, but mnaishi, kwa mtu anajua when you walk. Boda boda ikura na kupigia honi, na kuwa bei, ndi kubebe. You know, boda boda ikupigia honi, it means that you are blessed. Unakao kwa na pesa, is that true? Boda boda isi simamishia chokwa na mwa piki piki. Eh, lakini ya kuwa ni msaji, unapina jwa this man, has money. Kume ya unatabia na mgu because of poverty, ya? Yeah? Why? Because the glory of God is upon you. The cloud of grace is upon you. And once this cloud of grace is upon you, even if you are going through hardship, or you are walking through the valleys of shadows of death, yes, when people look at you, they will say that this man is blessed. You have nothing at that time. Why? Because of what you used to do in future. What a man soweth, the same he shall reap. So you are not wasting your resources. You are not wasting your time. The Lord is with you, and in due season, you must reap in Jesus' mighty name. Let us stand with our feet. God. Amen.
Amen.
Yes. The Spirit of God is urging me to tell you this. Today, very early in the morning, this person used to be a member here. Now, so this person, Pastor Tony, how is our church doing? Where is our church? How? I thought that you left us. When you went to anyway. Amen. Because my organizer is in fact, we see a party to the Wachia. Ile pesa ya kununua land imefikia wapi? Nikamwambia wewe ndio ulikuwa the solicitor wa hiyo kit. Wewe ndio unafaa uje revive that project. Nikasema kweli. Kweli bwana, nimekosea sana. Nimekaa sana bila kuja church yetu. Now this man told me that I'm gonna aliniambia ako na church. Alienda kwa church ingine mahali. So anasema hiyo kanisa alienda sambaratika. Na alikuwa na advice mpaka the pastor and the bishop of that church. Akuja kwa mshirika wetu kwa kipole. Why? Because hiyo kanisa ilikuwa nyingiza tupu. Eh? According to his level of understanding. Eh? Nikasema hii tena ni mambo gani? I'm not even a bishop. Unaambia bishop akuja kwa chini yetu. So wananiambia amepatia washirika more than 15 namba zangu za simu. Yeah. Na washirika wanataka kukuja huko. Wanauliza ngai hiyo kanisa iko wapi? Na wajawahi tuona wanatusikianga tu. Bwana asifiwe sana. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
So this man amesema zile project zote za kanisa zinaendelea aje? What about the Iris Kitty? What about the hizo pesa kwa nataka za keyboard za nini za kukuza? Hiyo kanisa yetu iko aje? Watu wako aje siku hizi? Viti ziko ngapi? Hey, was really shocked. Nisema wewe, hebu nikuze namba ya tatu. Wewe bado ni wetu. Sasa wewe nani alikuambia mimi nimewacha church? Mimi sikuwa nimewacha church. Na ndio sasa wewe mwenyewe ndio uliniambia umewacha church. Sikuwa ni hapo kuwacha church bado uliniambia una shiriki kwingine. Akasema no. Kwa sababu kwingine sikuwacha church. I'm a member of that church. Hey. That thing is really lifted me. Na nilikuwa nauliza Mungu today. Tumeomba hizo siku zote. Why are we not? Kumbe we have something special.
Amen.
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 Bwana asifiwe sana. So let us not despise ourselves. Because what we are talking. And let me tell you this. Sikujisifu ama kiburi ama anything. Ama kufanya kanisa hilo the only true church in Kenya. No, we have many, many true churches in Kenya. Watu wengi wametoka in this church. Wamekuwa wakituacha. Without even announcing. But where they are, they still believe that they are our members. Mbaka this man alikuwa anasema, alikuwa anaenda hiyo church. Akiulizwa mahali kanisa yao inaitwa anaenda anasema ni end time gospel mission. See, new life, family, end time gospel mission. So, wale pali walienda, hawakupata the grace that iko hapa. I'm not saying that we are holy than thou. Even Tony is just a man. Like you, and maybe Tony has weaknesses like you. What has it been, sir?
Amen.
Amen. But the churches that you are seeing, who in Jaiji, most of them, they are not real, they are not legit. Zikona mambo mingi, zikona haluba news, ningi, kona ukora, janja. And I normally tell people, okay, talk up or wait every game, I'm telling you, utarudi tu. Utarudi tu ambi. Because what is here cannot be found anywhere. Ukuinje, ovyo, unless the Lord directs you. Do you know that?
Yes.
Do you know that?
Yes.
Tuna pastor wetu wako very humble. Ana kujanga, anapanga viti, anafagia, anatoka, anaenda. Uwe sikia pastor wetu amepigania sadaka. Hata hajoingi sadaka kutoka ndani. Pastor wetu sakina anakujanga, yeye ndio senior pastor. Mi nakuja nasema, mpaka masaa inaenda. Na anakuja nasema, hey, hiyo tonia mahubiri imetosha, naomba. Ushaona pastor kama huyo anyway. Ya? Yeah? Hey, and you are ready, mtu yote unataka kuhubiri anakama mbogo chini. Ukiambia pastor, I want to preach, anakuambia preach, chukua my spell to preach. No, no. Come on, Bebaliki, oh, Bebaliki. Don't take this man of God for granted. One has a few words. And you are very genuine. We pray in truth and in spirit.
Yes.
Yeah? We need to know you are from We are very legit and very genuine. That's the other one broke, isn't it? What does it feel like? Sometimes, we just get a person up here, we just get a party, we just get to come here anyway. Yeah? Hey, that's a bear, sir, but you put it out. No, but I'm survival is not a millionaire. They love that I'm a trek from where he lives to here. So, getting such a judge is a miracle. Do you know that? Hey, when you want to talk about our church, what are you saying? Kenya, we do to do. We know everything because we are prophets. We know we are not going to say na we are he and a great story in a hero. We know all these things. But just the other pastor is mama account here. At the moment, I talk about Nisa. Have you ever heard such a thing? No. Not what you keep, not you rude. So we are blessed. And don't take this blessing for granted. Yeah? Amen.
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 We are not a business enterprise. We just come with party behind the curtains. I can come and you in one corner. Just come to get your own party. Hey, you know, you're here. No. Yeah? Amen. Hey, so you're in the jungle, you're not going to be here. You're not going to be here. In fact, you can't have pastors. I'll say, I'll be here. I'll take out when I pay a mingi. What's the idea? What? I'll take it. What's the idea? What's the idea? In fact, you're going to find the opposite. That's what they say. But I'll give you some. Is that true? That means, we are not here for business.
Yes.
We are not here for business. Yeah? And we don't follow those who give and those who don't. We don't segregate at who you are the person who is in Chirika. No, we don't do something. But the point is, And that is what is happening to those who left. And announced. That is a fact. I don't come on now. It didn't work. They don't yet say. What has it been?
Amen.
And then what? They don't yet say. I'm the part of grace. Even the part of entering anywhere.
Yes.
After I come out, the church is not rich. After I come out, you're not a gun for now. You will never get to see such a church anywhere.
Yes.
Eh? Eh?
Yes.
Yes, because I think it's been from the missing here, my genie, Mizizi, or my Bible, isn't it? Yeah? But he is what you know, my paper, Ganga, but it is just this book, 66 books, and the Holy Spirit. Fisher, I don't have anything apart from this. Our pastors, the same. Amen.
Amen.
Because why if you kill you, to see Yaki Masengenyo, Matusi, Madaral, Naana, Kwaad. Don't ask here, we are prophets. I'm going to say, so what is that? Huh? It is not as long as I can decide the pastor. Who is photo a pesa, pastor, and I can decide and I can get there. What is that? But I'm a pastor, why do you want me to say, come on, affair? The book would be good, you want to come and start with a dear affair. Yeah, come after me, warning. I want us to be rich.
I'll give you what I have with a banner. Then I said, yeah, I'm sure I don't have to make my statements.
So let me tell you this. Yeah? The grace that is in entering, Nasiku Nisifu, I'm not bragging, cannot be found elsewhere.
Yes.
Of your own, unless the Lord is on you.
Yes.
Yeah? Amen.
Amen.
Yes, mimi kuja kwangu hata kama una kitu, hata kama umepata, nataka kukaribisha tukae, tukule, uoge, survive, uishi. Nyumba yako itaenda flex. Do you know that? Do you know that? Do you know what I mean? You know me, yeah? Ni kweli ni uongo? Grace kama hiyo huwezi pata anywhere.
Yes.
You can't get it anywhere. Anywhere. There was a day I was with another pastor. Let me finish with this. Tuwagana na pastor wake. That pastor ajui mimi ni pastor. Pastor huyu ni mshirika wake. Huyo pastor akaambia mshirika sina fare nipatie pesa. Sasa ajui kama mshirika ana fare man. So mshirika akatoa akampatia. Hiyo pesa ndo alikuwa anakununua nayo chakula ya watoto. You see? Na kama akempatia yake, huyo pastor akemlaanya. That's how that pastor operates. I really pity that pastor. And these are the dramas that are outside there. So in entering, atujawahi kuwa na akili ya biashara. Anywhere. Na tujawahi kuwa na akili ya ati macheo, ati za kanisa, ati tunangangania ucheo. No, akili yetu is taking people to Christ. That's why pastor alisema hapa last Sunday, that if this church is not blessing you, ona mlango, tafuta ile itakubariki, isn't it? Like because our intention and our mission is Jesus Christ, training soldiers of Christ as we were in mass. This slogan yetu ni training soldiers of Christ. As, let me add something there. As we were in this. We are telling you and we were in this. We don't know if you give us or not, if you bless us or not. You just get the training free of charge. You want to know about the training free of charge? It is a lot of money to pay your money for school fees and universities. Huh? But here we train you for free as we do what? As we were in this. What does it feel like? So the grace that is here is a grace beyond.
Grace.
Don't take it for granted. In fact, we have to pray, telling God, "Asante because of entering." Yeah, we have never seen our pastor cursing up Shirika, who has left us. In fact, they left us. They leave. Now we are to learn. We are to say, "Kenya, we are to wonder." But akuna na sumbona chayo waiskia, namda waiskia to be discussed. Those who left. Ama waiskia behind the curtains. Either me, Pastor Osh, Brother Basi. Brother Uchuka, Brother Osborne, now we can. We scare them here about those who left. No, we scare them alive. No, but the boy know what I've done. Hey, we only need, we only need, we only need, we only need, we only need this for my food. We only less because we have Jesus Christ. And Christ in the Bible says, do not worry.
Yes.
Amen. So now we're going to go to the Buddha. So come baby, come. We love you. We love you. Come back to your church. We've already had our answers. So we don't have any kinyongo with anyone. Yeah? We don't have any kinyongo with our gossipers. Let them gossip. Let the filthy be filthy, steal. Let the righteous be righteous, steal. Behold, I'm coming quickly, says the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Don't take for granted. Don't think that you can just walk out of this church whether you are given or feet. Utaona makasoro mingi, nikotoka uko mbio, 100 meters, mpaka hapa. Because unajiona unajidanganya, you know that. So our mission is taking people to where? To Christ. It's not kujaza watu in church, kujaza watu kwa tumetee sadaka, tukule, tutuwe matumbo. No, that's not our mission. That is not our, and you never see me asking you for money. You never see our pastor doing that. And this is what our pastor has been teaching us since the foundation of this church was laid. Somewhere in Matthias Lavungo. Our mission is taking people where? To Jesus Christ. But our blessing will come from who? From God. Amen.
Amen.
Yeah, our blessing will not come from the people, but from God. That's why we don't even care. At we are at door to Nandika list. We don't do that. Yeah? And that's why our giving is discreet. When you give in this hand, let this hand not know what this other hand is doing. Because we are not concentrated so much in your giving. We are concentrated in Jesus Christ, the maker of the heavens and the earth, the giver of everything. So don't take this grace for granted. In Jesus' name, let us stand in our feet. Oh, yale umesema, yale umesema. And may the Lord give you the grace to give as per his will. Because your future is not based on what you keep, but your maker in heaven. Let us tell God that if our hoarding is the reason why our blessings are stinking, may the Lord cleanse us and refresh us in Jesus' name. Let us go before the Lord. Oh, dear Lord, dear Christ, thank you, Father, because of today. May your name be glorified in Jesus' name.
Thank you.
thing in this earth. It is called the goodness of God. There are people who are feeling good. You are just here feeling good. Do you have people who are feeling good here? Yeah, you're just feeling good. Yes? The stress have left. You just feel relaxed and good. Oh, may that goodness follow you all the days of your life. In Jesus' mighty name. May the goodness of God dwell in your heart forever and ever. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Thank you. Come for the Lord.